at the Institute, he kept pretty much to himself. I think he ate with us occasionally, but he didn't say very much. He kept pretty much to himself, and there was no reason. I didn't have anything to say to him, except, you know, I admire you very much, and so on and so forth, and whatever. But then I'd been to New York or somewhere, and I came back, and Dyson and I were on the same train, and we found ourselves in the same odd, we're stuck in the same station outside of Princeton. And somehow, we had a car, took a taxi, or anyway, we went back to his house. We had some drinks. And we talked a lot. Now, it turned out that he was in the process of getting a divorce. So he was living by himself in this house. And he was a little bit, I think, he was more open to this. So we talked. After that, we became pretty good friends. And of course, we never worked together. We did work on the Orion together, but I couldn't contribute anything to anything Dyson was doing. He is so fast and so incredibly smart